Hey guys, it's Nicole, and this is going to be a book review on my two favorite lab and diagnostic books. If I don't have any room in my book bag or I have a free pocket, I use this book here called Lab Notes. It has labs in it. It has diagnostic testing from CAT scan to MRI to nuclear tests and anything and everything lab and diagnostic related. It's a pocket version, so each lab has maybe a sentence or two, and each diagnostic type of test has a sentence or two. But it does in particularly give you the pre-op testing information and the post-op testing information. It does elaborate on that if needed. The one that I carry in my bag as a 100% encyclopedia of lab and diagnostic testing is this book here. I've had this book since my nursing school days, and I have no intentions of getting rid of it or selling it. This book is so valuable. Unlike the Lab Notes pocket version, this book here elaborates on why these labs are elevated and decreased. It gives you reasons. It also tells you that this test in conjunction with another test is to result in the following. Like amylase and lipase put together, if both are really high, usually are due to acute pancreatitis. This book would tell you exactly that. This book, on top of labs, has diagnostic testing like the Lab Notes pocket version as well, but it is in far greater detail and much more amazing. I have patients with chronic conditions, acute conditions, a mishmash of the two, and sometimes you get a whole bunch of abnormal labs. But it's up to you to distinguish or determine what's chronic versus what's acute, and this book really helps you out. Sometimes there's labs that over a period of time are elevated in chronic conditions, and there are labs over a certain period of time are decreased in acute conditions. This book goes into detail about labs. I use this book to make my nursing care plans, my concept maps in nursing school, and it was a really great resource. These two guys are my lab and diagnostic, you know, buddies, my resource books I always go to. I have intentions of, I think this book here has a new edition, which I'll be buying soon because this book is valuable. And this is also a book that I carry in my book bag when I go to work, because nothing is more frustrating to me than a patient going for a test and them asking me, well, what's going to happen? What am I going to have to do there? Am I going to have to stay and lay down? How long is it going to take? And I'd be completely clueless about what's going on. We all know how x-rays go, but some CAT scans require contrast, non-contrast. There are some tests that last 1 to 4 hours. You should be able to present your patient with some sort of information. So this book is valuable. I'll put a link below, but this is a really great book that I carry to work all the time. And it saves me from the dangers of Googling, because we all know Google's awesome, but as far as accurate medical sources to tests and labs, it's a little skewed. So this is also a really great resource when you don't have the internet with you. So let me show you these two things one more time. I'll put a link for this as well. And here is this amazing book I love and fall in love with. Had it for 2 years, wouldn't trade it for the world, and getting another copy. If you guys have any questions or comments for me, as always, put them on the bottom. Stay tuned for book and pocketbook picks at the end, and have a good day, guys. Bye.